It seems like there might also be a ton of other considerations, you know, if you're thinking about like hearing impairment, visual impairment. When people are designing for all these users, can you compromise the design? Will the product maybe change too much?
Yeah, it's a very good question. And there definitely does seem like there's a lot at first glance to really consider. And in actuality, if you do leave all of these considerations to the end of the product cycle, it can compromise the product because there's a lot of rethinking and refactoring that needs to go in to just kind of fit these things in. And so that's why we're always asking people and informing and educating people on how to think of these things early on. I think when you just look at the general steps within the design process, all of the points of that when you're thinking about accessibility, they're integrated in every step that you're already thinking about. So again, with color contrast, you're already thinking about what is your color palette going to be. So then just on top of that, you have some additional standards to maybe try to follow and look at to ensure that there's enough contrast there. Hey, we're here at the OXO website. I wanted to bring this up because I feel like they have a really good approach to universal design, and they have this great quote on here that I wanted to read. When we talk about designing for accessibility or universal design, it's important to note that that does not mean designing products fully usable by everybody, since there is no product that can truly fulfill the needs of all users. But when all users' needs are taken into consideration in the initial design process, the result is a product that can be used by the broadest spectrum of users. So I feel like that's a great way to kind of sum up that, yes, there is a lot to consider, but it's not about making compromises. In the end, when you do consider these things up front, you end up with a better product overall.
Yeah, that's great. And how can an entrepreneur learn more about accessibility? What resources are available to them?
The great thing is there's a lot of resources out there online. A few, just to kind of rattle off, are the Web Content Accessibility Guidelines, which you can find online. That's a really thorough list of standards that you would want to meet and need to meet. And they have great examples on there as well and resources. There are different companies have provided their own design guidelines. Google is one of them, which you can see here. This is the Google accessibility website, and these are design guidelines that we came up with, which are based on a lot of the standards that were developed by the Web Content Accessibility Guidelines. Apple has a great resource as well for their accessibility design guidelines. And there's also some really interesting tools out there. There's plugins. There's a plugin called CSEE that allows you to kind of simulate what your page or site would look like with different vision impairments as well as color blindness.
Wow.
So there's a lot that's out there.
Great.